The purpose of this video is to show that the sine function is odd and that the cosine function is even. And just to give you a reminder of these definitions real quick, and I'll post a card back to the video where these came from, an even function has the algebraic property that f of negative x is equal to f of x, and the graph will have symmetry about the y-axis. An odd function has the algebraic property that f of negative x is the negative of f of x, and the graph will have rotational symmetry about the origin, meaning if you spin the graph by 180 degrees about the origin, you get a copy of the original graph. So in our first example, we're trying to show that the sine function is odd. And we accomplish this by going back to where the sine function was defined, and that's the unit circle. So this radius is 1. And I labeled an angle of x and an angle of negative x because I want to compare the sine of x and the sine of negative x to do this algebraic test. Well, the sine of x is just the y-coordinate of this point by definition. That's how the sine function was originally defined. And the sine of negative x is the y-coordinate of this point. And I can immediately see by symmetry that these y-coordinates have equal magnitudes but opposite signs. In other words, they're negatives of each other. And so I find that the sine of negative x is the opposite, the negative, of the sine of x, and that proves that the sine is an odd function. So if we're correct about the sine being an odd function, it should exhibit the rotational symmetry I was talking about. Let's take a look at the graph real quick. There's the graph of the sine function, and you can see if you took the origin as the rotation axis and spun this thing by 180 degrees, the graph would land right on top of the original graph. So I am getting the correct rotational symmetry out of this. In the next example, we do a similar thing with the cosine function. Show that the cosine function is even. So again, I've labeled an angle of x and an angle of negative x on the unit circle. The cosine, by definition, is the x-coordinate of the point on the unit circle corresponding to each of these angles. And I can immediately see from the graph that the x-coordinate of those two points is exactly the same number. All right, so cosine x and cosine negative x are yielding precisely the same x-coordinate. So I can write down cosine of negative x is the same thing as the cosine of x. And we've shown that the cosine function is even. So let's look at a graph of it real quick. And when I plot the cosine function, I do see that symmetry about the y-axis that I'm supposed to see for even functions. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.